وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ This is the identity of the Muslim. Whoever discovers لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ then indeed he has discovered himself and he has found his purpose in life. Look at يعني from أذكار الصباح اللهم إني أصبحت أشهدك وأشهد حملة عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله شوف أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك You wake up in the morning and you're saying Oh Allah, I appoint you as a witness Oh Allah, you bear witness that I have woken up this morning and your angels to bear witness and the carriers of the throne to bear witness and all of your creation to bear witness to the fact that I wake up this morning or I enter the evening having declared faith and certainty that there is no Lord worthy of worship but you. وحدك لا شريك لك. الله أكبر. No partners for you. Subhanallah. For we ask Allah Azza wa Jal that He allow us to live upon لا إله إلا الله and die upon لا إله إلا الله. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. If the last word you uttered in this worldly life was لا إله إلا الله, such a person enters the paradise. الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله, he said, it is not necessary that you utter the words لا إله إلا الله. Because if a person was dying, let's say, and he was in an unconscious state, and he was out of it in a coma and so on, then if he lived the state of لا إله إلا الله during his life, surely he is included in this hadith. And this is why the one who reads Ayat al-Kursi after every salat and then dies before the next salat, what was the reward? دخل الجنة. He enters the paradise. Why? Because the hadith said to you, whoever says لا إله إلا الله and that's his last words, enters the paradise. And what is Ayat al-Kursi other than Allah لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم الله أكبر